Welcome everybody, I'm Fabio Viviani and this is Fabio's Kitchen, where every week I'm bringing you a simple dish made by me. Fettuccini with red beets and goat cheese. Fettuccine con le barbabietole rosse. Rape, come si chiama? What's the name of beets in Italian? In Italy. Rape, no? Shit, I forgot. Anyway, wow, I forgot the name of beets in Italian. Keep rolling, I gotta Google this. Wait, I forgot. What's the name of, what the? My country is not gonna be happy right now. I forgot the name of red beets in Italian. Beets in Italian. Barbabietole, I thought I said it right. Yes, fettuccini with barbabietole, formaggio di capra e basilico fresco. Siamo fuori di testa. Although I forgot the name, this dish is amazing. It happens, guys. I spent my whole life now in the United States for the last 15 years. This is what it is. Anyway, for red beet fettuccini, the first things we do is to cook the fettuccini, all right? I'm gonna use, again, dry pasta. Simple reason. If after all this episode of Fabio's Kitchen, you still haven't learned how to make fresh pasta, you should literally avoid cooking altogether or buy dry pasta, right? So we're gonna make dry pasta because who can make fresh pasta can make it. And you, that you're looking at me like all dumb right now because you have no idea how to make fresh pasta, you use dry pasta, they're still delicious. La pasta fresca è meglio per le fettuccine con le barbabietole, però se non la sapete fare, che non avete guardato nessun episodio di Fabio in cucina, allora chiaramente prendete la pasta secca. Io che posso mica stare a farvi da babysitter, da badante o tutti i giorni a fare la pasta fresca. Allora, pasta fresca non c'è, si fa la pasta secca. Olio extravergine d'oliva e cipolla va in padella. Extravergine olive oil and onion. White onion goes into a pan. Onion add a good layer of flavor and some caramelization for the fettuccine. I'm gonna let this cook for a few minutes until they're nice and golden. Pepper. I like to cook pepper in the oil. It gives it a nice toasty note. Cipolla soffritta, bella colorata, dorata. Guardate che bellezza. La cipolla c'ha un profumo meraviglioso quando cuoce. Golden onion. Now we add the beets. Now, barbabietole, beets. I buy them at the store, cooked and peeled. They're very convenient. Se le volete cuocere, pelare, fatelo da voi. Però ci sono tantissimi supermercati che vendono le barbabietole rosse già cotte, pelate, che è un po' più facile per chi è a casa. For the home cook, it's a lot easier. A little bit of vegetable broth. And a touch of cream. Just a touch. This is some really nice reduced vegetable broth. Brodo vegetale ridotto, è buonissimo. Fate il brodo vegetale, ne fate tipo 5-6 litri e poi lo fate ridurre di 3 quarti. Vi viene concentrato, saporito, meraviglioso. This is a perfect base, concentrated vegetable stock like you start with like 10 gallon and then you reduce it down to one. It's delicious for things like minestrone and soup in general. Out of this world. Out of here. Quando la pasta è quasi cotta, si mette in padella. And we're gonna let the pasta cook in the sauce to absorb the beet, the juices, the beet color, the juices. Pasta's gonna be nice and pink, it's beautiful. Appena la pasta è al dente, si mette nella padella con le barbabietole e si fa ritirare con il brodo vegetale e un po' di panna. Molta gente in Italia non cucina con la panna perché la panna camuffa i sapori. Ci sono dei piatti che la cremosità della panna aggiunge molto. There are some dishes that the creaminess of heavy cream add a lot texture to it. I'm not a big fan of cooking with heavy cream, but in some dishes, it makes sense a little bit. Ora, formaggio caprino. Guardate che bellezza. Look how gorgeous this is. Look how beautiful this is. Formaggio caprino nel piatto, saltato e sopra. Basilico fresco, un po' d'olio d'oliva. Piatto meraviglioso alla barbabietola con la pasta. Fantastico. Perfect dish, rich, creamy, delicious. I love red beet. They're very earthy. It's like a better potato. I absolutely love it. And then the dish is gorgeous. Fresh basil, a little bit of goat cheese on top for the contrast of color, red and white. It's a beautiful dish because you're watching Fabio's Kitchen. Questo dish è meraviglioso. Questo piatto fantastico. Guarda che bellezza. Barbabietole, basilico fresco, brodo vegetale, cipolla rosolata con le fettuccine. That's it. We got it. Hey guys, since you have been watching, now how about you go share it with everybody you know? Come on, thank you.